Shopify Pixels just got some spicy new features. Hello everyone, Christian here. We have a new feature alert with customer events and a Shopify Pixels dedicated area. Let's check it out. Now, if you're not familiar with Pixels, these are code snippets that collect and track behavioral customer data for either marketing, reporting, etc. So for example, if clicking a link or adding a product to cart, those events get tracked with Pixels. Now, third-party services like Facebook or TikTok that are integrated with your store use the customer event data that they collect using Pixels to optimize your marketing automations and analytics. Now, that was just a quick overview of what Pixels are and what they do, and you probably are already using some Pixels. Now, what's changed here is the location or where these pixels are going to live. So previously you could manually add the JavaScript snippets in several places in your online store. That would be in your online preferences, in your checkout scripts, and in apps. So like the checkout, if we go here from settings to checkout and we scroll all the way here to the bottom, you can see we actually have a bunch of scripts in here. So you could add additional scripts right within here. You could also do it under online store and then preferences. And you have Google Analytics in here. We have the Facebook Pixel. I think that's the only one in there. And then lastly, you can also go to online store and click on the three dots and then edit code. And then from here, go into that theme.liquid. You would be basically adding code. You've probably added code in the past to some of these sections right here. Now, the problem with these is that these weren't usually quality control and they're actually time consuming to manage. Even like when you upgrade from this theme to a better theme, you will probably have to manually copy those and paste them into the new one or manipulate different things or change things. So it has been a pain to manage these pixels on the Shopify right now. So with this new sort of pixel manager, your scripts are stored in a single management tool and run in a sandbox environment. Now, adding these pixels to your store in this new section can provide the following benefit. Get access to a stream of customer events on your online store, including checkout events. You actually get an additional layer of security for your online store and your customers, including greater control over the customer data that you share with third-party services like Facebook and TikTok. You also get prevention of third-party code running non-performing JavaScript or interfering with your online store and checkout. So things should run smoother and not take as long as they did before. And you also get built-in tools for privacy compliance. Now, pixels can be added to your online store in two ways, through app pixels, which are installed through marketing and data collection apps, and through custom pixels, which can be manually added by a developer or yourself in the Pixels Manager. But before we do that, I was gonna do an intro, but I think you guys know who I am, so I'm not gonna do that. Instead, I'm going to tell you a joke. And this is not my joke, by the way. This is coming straight from ChatGPT. So the joke goes like this. Why was a Facebook pixel feeling depressed? Because it was constantly being tracked and monitored, but never given any likes or comments. If you don't know about ChatGPT, you definitely need to look into ChatGPT. Really, really cool software, really cool things that they're doing. And you can ask it for jokes like these, so maybe don't do that part. All right, so let's get back into the video. Let's talk about app pixels. So app pixels are scripts that are installed as part of a third-party app or sales channel. These pixels are created by the app owner and they're set up to use a sort of strict isolated environment on your store. The isolated environment called the sandbox uses Shopify controlled APIs to collect or retrieve data. So they reduce the overall impact to the performance of your store, the security and the privacy of your website. So that's actually a really good thing. So whenever you can and it's available to use, I would use the app pixel because they will be better for your store in the long run. When you install an app that has an app pixel, it's your responsibility to know what information these pixels are collecting and to set up the appropriate tools to obtain customer consent prior to the actual collection. So what we're trying to say here is that even if you're adding, you know, TikTok and it automatically creates the pixel for you and it adds it to the app pixels, and you install Facebook and it adds a new Facebook pixel and it adds it to your app pixels, it's still your responsibility to change those things in your website's privacy settings or privacy policy and your terms of service and all that kind of stuff. and let your customers know that they're being tracked by the TikTok Pixel, they're being tracked by the Facebook Pixel, they're being tracked by Hotjar. All these things are very, very important that you include right within your privacy settings, terms of service, those policies that should be at the footer on your site. So let's check out where you can actually manage these app pixels. Now to find this, we'll go to settings right here, and then you should see a new sort of tab link right here. It's called customer events. When you click on that, it will give you the two options. It will give you the custom pixels and then the app pixels. So again, the app pixels will be automatically added depending on what apps or sales channels you have that automatically adds these. And once you install those apps, they will automatically be here so that you can manage them from here. So you can't necessarily add them from right here, but this is the place where you'll see them listed. Hey, also want to remind you, we have that new Shopify VIP Day service. If you're interested in getting on the waitlist, please check the link in the description below. Okay, now let's talk about the custom pixels. So these help you collect customer events on even more pages of your online store, such as the checkout and post-purchase pages, that thank you page. If there isn't an app pixel available that meets your requirements, then you can actually use a custom pixel on your store to track customer events without having to modify your theme code, which is what we talked about previously. Now, adding custom pixels can be tricky, and you will need to customize your code so that it works properly. I have a link that breaks down how to do that, but it requires some HTML knowledge. I do think that they do a good job of explaining it, and in a future video, we'll definitely be going more specific on like how to add the Facebook pixel or how to add the TikTok pixel on a custom pixel sort of event, right? So that we actually have more detailed instructions for you on how to do that. But if you want to start tinkering with them, then check the link in the description below, which talks about how to do that. Now, before you even do that, just know that you will have to remove any of the old existing pixels to ensure that customer events aren't being counted twice. So keep that in mind. Existing pixel code should be manually removed from any place that it exists. So it could be in the theme.liquid, it can be in the checkout settings that we just saw, or yeah, those additional scripts, you know, during the checkout settings. So you definitely want to make sure that you're looking for all those places. And then when it comes to the actual, like, when I say like you have to do customizations to the code, you basically have to sort of strip the HTML from it and put it in here as sort of a like a raw JavaScript, basically. So this is the link that I will be sharing with you, but if you can see this, they give you an example for the Facebook or the Meta pixel. But as you can see, like this code right here has like the script right here, and it has the this over here. So all this sort of carrots are all part of like HTML. So they basically tell you to remove the HTML, and then there's gonna be some additional things that you'll have to do in order to sort of manipulate the code so that it's all just JavaScript. So things like this last part of it, the source, you'll have to manipulate that to change it into sort of JavaScript version of that code. So they also do it with the Google Analytics pixel in here. But again, we will do a separate video where we'll actually teach you exactly how to do this so you don't mess this up. Now, if you want that video, you want it immediately, please let us know in the comments below that you want that video so that we'll make it quicker for you. And yeah, the process for adding the pixels, once you get that done, then it will be just as simple as going in here, adding the custom pixel, naming it, and then just adding your JavaScript right within here. But like I said, that video that we'll do will connect everything for you. We'll also even test it to make sure that these are working correctly. All those things are very important, and I think they should be done properly. And in a video, in a separate video where we can actually test it and let you know how to properly do that for you. Now, this is something that everyone, I think, essentially will have to transition to, just because it's so much easier to manage your pixels from this place and not having it into three different places on your online store. Plus, like I said earlier, when you're upgrading your theme, which you should be doing probably every quarter, then this will make that process a lot simpler because your pixels are living somewhere else. Hopefully you enjoy this. This is a new feature. If you have any questions about it, please let us know in the comments below so that we can address them in that next video that we'll create for you. See you in the next one. Bye.